I'm going to teach you how to use as well as, and you're going to learn exactly how to add this to your speech in grammatically correct sentences. Now, this is an expression that lots of my students have recommended recently, mainly because I taught them how to use as long as and also as soon as. And a lot of people in the comments asked me to teach them as well as. So this video is for all of you. Of course, I'm Jennifer from JForrestEnglish.com, and this channel is dedicated to helping you sound like a fluent, confident, natural English speaker. Now, before we go any further, make sure you subscribe and hit that bell notification so you're notified every time I post a new video. Now, let's dive in with this lesson. In this video, I'm going to teach you how to add as well as to your vocabulary. Now, before we go any further, I gotta level with you. This is an advanced expression, okay? And this is an expression that sometimes even native English speakers don't use correctly. So, if you don't feel like you're at that advanced level, or if you're struggling with this lesson, that's okay, it might just be a little too advanced for you. So just keep that in mind. Now, with that said, let's talk about as well as. The reason why I said it's more of an advanced topic and even sometimes native English speakers struggle with it is because as well as does not mean the same thing as and, okay? And this is where I see a lot of students and even sometimes some native English speakers make mistakes. And it's the context, okay? It's the context that you use this expression that has to make sense. In many sentences, you would just use and rather than as well as. So just keep that in mind as I'm explaining this to you. So, as well as, what does this mean? You can think of this to mean as not only Y, but also X, okay? Not only, but also. So in that case, it doesn't just mean and just means and. As well as means not only, but also. And because of that, because it has this more specific usage, when you use this is going to be way more limited than when you simply just say and, okay? Now, let's look at the structure here. To form this, we would have X as well as Y. Okay, so we would need to put information in for X and Y. But remember my explanation, I said not only Y, but also X, okay? The order of that is important because we're saying not only Y, so this item, whatever Y is, but also X, and we're emphasizing X. That's the important thing. We're emphasizing X, and X is the one that comes first. Now, I promise this is going to make sense when you see it in an example. So let's take a look at an example. I could say, we're accepting applications from Harvard as well as Princeton. Okay, so think about this. From Harvard as well as Princeton. So we have X and Y, right? What's X? Put it in the comments. What's X? The one that comes first. Harvard is X. And what's Y? Put it in the comments. What's Y? Y equals Princeton. The second one is Y. In this case, X, Harvard, Y, Princeton, okay? So not only Y, not only Princeton, but also Harvard, but also X. And remember, which one are we emphasizing? Let me know in the comments. Are we emphasizing X, Harvard, or are we emphasizing Y, Princeton? Put it in the comments. Emphasizing which one, X or why? Put it in the comments. We're emphasizing X. We're emphasizing Harvard. We're emphasizing the first one. And that's the important thing, because I could say we're accepting applications from Harvard and Princeton. I could simply use and, okay? But the meaning is slightly different, but an important distinction. When we use and, we see those, the X and the Y, we see them as equal in terms of importance, okay? But when we use as well as, we're emphasizing X for whatever reason. So that's an important distinction. That's why I said at the beginning that in many cases, you're just going to use and. You're going to mention two items that you do, and they're going to have equal importance, okay? Now, using our same example, why, the thing that comes at the end, can be plural. And in many cases, it will be plural, okay? So I could say, we're accepting applications from Harvard, X, that's still Harvard. We're accepting applications from Harvard as well as other universities. So other universities, why? That's plural. And remember, it's like saying, not only are we accepting applications from other universities, but we're also accepting applications from Harvard with emphasis on Harvard. So in both these examples, the one where I had a singular Princeton and then plural other universities, we're emphasizing Harvard in both of those examples. So now it's your turn to practice in the comments. I want you to form a sentence using as well as. Remember, we need, in terms of structure, we need X as well as Y. And remember, it means not only Y, but also X with emphasis on X, right? So put an example sentence in the comments. Now, after you do that, and honestly, this will probably take you a little while to think of the correct context that you need for that. Now, after that, I also want you to just put a simple sentence using and, okay? So X and Y, and there's going to be equal emphasis on X and Y. And I want you to do that so you can really see them side by side, see as well as, and see and side by side, and understand how they're not the same thing, and you can't use them interchangeably. And remember, like I said at the beginning, most likely you're going to form sentences with and. That's going to be way more commonly used in your daily vocabulary than as well as. Honestly, I don't remember the last time I really formed a sentence with as well as. So and is going to be very much a part of your daily vocabulary, where I don't think that as well as will be. But still, it's great to understand this distinction. Even if you don't use as well as very often, most likely you're going to see it being used, especially in a more academic style of writing. And in that case, you can understand how it isn't the same as and. So for me, some simple sentences I could say with and would simply be, I like, and then you name two things, or I want, and then you can name two things, or I bought, and then you can name two things, right? I like singing and dancing. I want a coffee and a croissant. I bought a shirt and a sweater. Now, taking one of those examples, I could say, the sweater I bought was beautiful as well as comfortable. So here, remember, not only Y, comfortable, but also X, with emphasis on the X, okay? So really get comfortable with seeing and as well as side by side. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button, share it with your friends, and of course, subscribe. Now, before you go, make sure you head on over to my website, jforrestenglish.com, and download your free speaking guide. In this guide, I share 6 tips on how to speak English fluently and confidently. And until next time, happy studying! All right, look at you adding this really advanced expression to your vocabulary. That's awesome, way to go. Don't stop there, make sure you check out this video and also this video. And don't forget to subscribe, and until next time, bye.